Hello once again, guys. Buzz Killington here, and the latest legendary event has begun, the Philosophies of War, allowing us to collect Shasso to our Shasera, you know, or Shadowsun if you just want to save yourself a lot of time. So yeah, I've 30 of 150 so far. I just thought in this video I'd have a quick look at how the event overall looks like it differs from previous legendary events, and what opportunities there might be here. So my plan with this one, I think, is not to really do the premium track at all, just to kind of see how far I can get using the units that I've got at the moment. It would be a push to unlock her in one go anyway, so I'm not sure I'm going to bother doing that this time around. What I have noticed is a few interesting things in the tracks. I think overall there's more opportunity here than there has been in previous tracks. So let's just draw attention to this. First off, we've got the Necrons in this one. Necrons aren't too bad in these events. The only sticking point in the Alpha track is the full big target lineup, and I'm going to demonstrate kind of the foibles with that in just a second. Well, as far as the Beta track goes, the opponents here are the Tyranids. We like the Tyranids. We have a lot of experience with the Tyranids. They don't have a lot of armor, so that's pretty useful. So we've got full mechanical as an option here. This one here, the full Astra Militarum, is going to be a little bit of a problem there. Like, obviously there are only 5 Astra Militarum characters. Most of you won't have all 5 anyway. I don't have Creed, but I do have the others. So immediately you're starting there at a little bit of a disadvantage. I mean, you can use Yarrick, obviously, if you've got Yarrick. Yarrick summons are handy, but you're only going to get 2 out because their numbers do depend on whether other summons are killed. You're not going to get any more of them. So you're going to get 2 supplemental troops. It's handy. It's not so bad. I would be more worried if it was against someone like Chaos and you were expected to do full Astra Militarum lineup. But since it is against Tyranids, that's not too bad, but it's not great depending on your levels. I mean, if you're like me, Yarrick will be your most beefed up Imperial Guard Astra Militarum character, and a lot of them will kind of be afterthoughts. I think I have the Psyker at Silver 1, Cutscoden is not anywhere near Silver 1, and I believe the Artillery guy Thaddeus Noble is something like Bronze 2. So it could be a little bit problematic as we progress, but it's not too bad overall. Gamma isn't too bad, I think. This is probably one of the best tracks. We do unfortunately have Snurper Derpers, which are a little bit of a problem to deal with at higher levels. But we have full Black Legion lineup, 120 teaching points just for those. So this isn't too bad, because if you've got the Fall of Cadia, you'll have your Black Legion reasonably leveled. Archimata should be fine. If you've been leveling Angrax, like I've recommended, shouldn't be too much of an issue. The other requirements really aren't too bad at all. Ranged, minimum 3 hits, power isn't too bad either. So there's definitely lots of opportunity here. That's what I think. But I'm going to show you quickly what I mean about the big targets track. We're going to try and do the big targets mission just to show the options that we've got available. So here we're just going to throw down this one here, no psychers. I mean, that's fine. You get this by default. But you can see here are our big target options. There's not a lot of opportunity here. A lot of you guys aren't going to have them. I know a few of you are going to have Reavis done, and probably done to a higher rank than me. Boss Gulgors isn't too bad, but yeah, no summons really, and no real opportunities for repairs of healing of any kind with the troops that you've got here. Cutscoden I'm not even going to put in. Overwatch opportunities are limited too, so kind of as it continues on, this is going to be a little bit more of a difficult track to accomplish. Especially when more difficult troops start getting busted out down the line. For the moment, things aren't too bad. Oh, and what are we going to do? So I'm trying to think of the best way to do this, really. I think there's not really any sophisticated tactics when you're using the big target track. You just kind of want to drop your troops in. I'm going to use the Overwatch and see how effective it can be. You just kind of want to sit around and wait, let them come out, and just kill them as they come. Not too bad early on, it must be said. Ugh, the Overwatch was completely useless because they all spawned over there. What an absolute pain. But yeah, you can see the limitations of this. There are no real opportunities for Overwatch or anything like that to kind of benefit you here. So that is a bit of an issue, I think. The Black Legion track, as I said, I think this is more opportunity for fun here. This is going to be pretty cool. So if we just teleport this guy here, for instance, this isn't the ideal position for him. I'm going to kind of show what we can do here. In maps like this, so he's actually done really well already. It really does benefit you just to try and shut off one of the pads, and where you can, just deploy everyone else. Just deploy Angrax to cover as many pads as you possibly can. You can see already this is starting to work pretty well. So we're going to push up here, try and block things off as best we can. Let's move this guy over here. And you can see Angrax is already starting to do good work here. What we want to do is just completely seal off this avenue of approach, which we are going to achieve in just a second. And now that we've done this, you can just sit here and basically double click, and the game is going to be over. Fun thing is, I don't think you even have to really kill that guy. You can just sit here and let them just continue to spawn and kill this one guy at the end. And this is a tactic, I think, with Black Legion that you can repeat pretty high up. Just if you've got Arcanum Artists at high level, just get some summons out, plop Angrax down, and just let him go to absolute town on them. So low effort, and just a really efficient use of your time, I think. There you go. Oh, the snipers are doing really good now, aren't they? Yeah. Alright, there we go. Done. Super easy and pretty fun to do, I've got to be honest there. And you get defeat all enemies, and you get full Black Legion. That's all you get, unfortunately, on that track. But if you're doing that the first time around, that is a decent number of points there. Very easy, very fun. There are a lot of good opportunities to use Angrax here, so I definitely advise you make the most of him. Alright, that's as far as my advice and my thoughts on philosophies of war go for the moment. Feel free to let me know in the comments, what do you think about this particular legendary event? Do you think you're going to have a good shout? Do you think you're going to struggle? Let me know. I think the big targets one is going to be an issue for me as I go further on. But we'll see how it goes. Let me know what you think. Thank you for watching. Until next time.